Hi, I'm Mr. Spiffy, and welcome to the bottom of the barrel. Today we're scraping off a whole new segment called Grading Your Output, where I give a report card to a wrestling pay-per-view. And today's report card goes to none other than just yesterday's WWE Night of Champions for 2010. Alright, so Night of Champions. We start off the night with a pay-per-view that really honestly was a I told you so pay-per-view. I got most of this card correct. Wasn't very hard to predict. Pretty straightforward. So we start off with Dolph Ziggler versus Kofi Kingston for the Intercontinental Championship. Was surprised by the outcome of this. They let Dolph go over clean. Alright, good. No problem with that. You know, I think it actually puts a little more thorn in the side of the whole situation with him and Vicky when he's having to yell at Vicky Guerrero to stop her from doing something fucking stupid like getting him disqualified and interfering in the matchup. Now, so if I had to give a grade to this match, it was a pretty basic match for Kofi and Dolph. They've had better, they've had worse. This match, grade C. Your next match on the card was Big Show versus CM Punk. Another match that did not come out the way I expected it to. I expected CM Punk to really pull out something, even if it was just a count-out victory. But, no. They put the Big Show over. Why? I don't know. He decimated the rest of, the Straight Edge Society. They're pretty much squashed into a bug. CM Punk obviously means very little to the company in the sense of being a really powerful heel, so I really don't know where this is going or what they're going to do with it, but hopefully this feud is over and that somehow or another CM Punk can get back on top. I like the Big Show, don't get me wrong, but this served no purpose, and all it's been really has been the entire feud's been very self-serving to the Big Show. Final verdict for this match was a D+. It really wasn't all that exciting. There was no drama. It just did nothing, and it was okay wrestling. All right, you got then the women's championship unification. Just as I predicted, Michelle McCool is the one who gets to go, and she comes out the winner. Now, what scares the fuck out of me is the fact that when she was announced the winner of the match, they said, and new undisputed Divas champion. Also, according to NoDQ.com, they are officially listing in the championship ranks. The last reigning women's champion is Layla. The current and new Divas champion is Michelle McCool. Fuck! We're gonna have to deal with that stupid butterfly belt. And after they touted up in the match that we have a championship that has almost 80 years of history, 80 fucking years of history, and we're going to absorb it into a belt that is 2 freaking years old, that is looks like crap, looks like something a little child would draw up and go and look, I got a belt, it's my championship, ooh! Fuck me. You know, so final grade for this matchup, with the botch that happened in it, plus one moment of laughter, which I'll tell you about in just a moment, I have to give this match a D. You know, it's pretty average, actually, for a Divas match, because Divas matches don't get much higher than Ds, unless they really, really work hard and show me something that isn't new. And considering that you had both Melina and Michelle McCool tumble off the top rope, almost injure themselves in the middle of a unification match, that was pretty bad. I think the one funny part about it was while Natalya was trying to hold back so that she didn't hurt anybody if they were really hurt, she goes, I'm gonna get you! Natalya, bless you for the comedy moment. I'd almost give the match extra points just for that. Alright. So the United States Championship match, one of the matches I was looking forward to. I've heard a lot of people say that they were upset because, not because Daniel Bryan won, but because they wanted this feud to extend. Just because Daniel Bryan won and he became United States Champion doesn't mean this feud's going to end right away. obviously, you know, after what happened at the main event, that they're not quite ready for Miz to cash in the Money in the Bank. I think they still got one or two good matches between Daniel Bryan and The Miz. But with the build-up that we've had for the last 6 months or so, this was a nice blow-off fight. And Daniel Bryan looked awesome. So did The Miz. Both of them put on a really good show that actually put together a good, decent story. This match is a solid A-. It could have gotten a little bit better, I think, if there had been more time given to this match and if they had really pushed the bar and if the WWE had allowed for maybe a little juicing or something like that. And I'm not one for advocating juicing, but this one could have used it. They'd been able to step up the violence just that much further. This match could have easily been an A or an A+. Daniel Bryan, new United States champion. Props up. I was right. Alright, then they have the World Heavyweight Championship match. This by far, besides the Daniel Bryan Miz match, was also the best match of the night. The storyline, the 13 years of history, and being a wrestling fan for almost 24 years, I can appreciate the history behind this match. And when you get down to it, these two were throwing punches like you would not believe. Certainly, there was not the bloody, brutal brawl that you'd expect from a no-holds-barred fight, but it was quality wrestling from Kane and Undertaker. That's saying a lot, because Kane is well known for being the man who has the same match every time he's in the ring, and this was not a typical Kane match. Even to the point that one of my co-workers, when I was taking a break and I was watching the pay-per-view online, he was watching the punches and he went, "Holy crap, I don't like wrestling, I think wrestling's fake," is what he tells me. But he's like, "For fake punches, those look really fucking real." And so, I gotta give props to Undertaker and props to Kane. They put on a really good match and told a really good story in the ring. Final score for this match was a solid A. These two are working really well and their promos are going really well. And I'm looking forward to Hell in a Cell when Undertaker will probably turn it around. I just wish Hell in a Cell wasn't in 2 fucking weeks! Alright. Fine, and then you got the Tag Team Turmoil match. Not what I expected for the Tag Team Championship, but the outcome was the same as I expected. Drew McIntyre, Cody Rhodes, new Tag Team Champions. WWE has zero confidence in the Hart Dynasty, and they probably want to remove them as far from TV as possible right now with Jim Neidhart's whole problem with drugs and breaking and entering. Sucks for them. This match was a basic Tag Turmoil. I've seen better, I've seen worse. This was a solid C match. Nothing special happened, wasn't all that unpredictable. Your final match of the card, the six-pack challenge. And this match, the first 5 minutes were really sad. I'm sorry, Chris Jericho loses out 2.5 minutes and has the sad exit out and they stop the match in the middle of it. I think that at least in honor of him, that's great, you know, that they do that, because this is definitely going to be his last match for a while. And, you know, if he's going on tour with Fozzy, I certainly hope he comes to my area. So, that was bad, and I think that left kind of a sour tone for the rest of the match. The rest of the match was pretty average and pretty predictable. I'm a little impressed that Wade Barrett was able to pin John Cena. Of course, he couldn't do it clean. He had to actually do it with a little bit of outside interference with Nexus. You know, God forbid John Cena put anybody over cleanly. And, you know, Randy Orton, WWE Champion. And, you know, seriously, what the fuck was with the long celebration? You know, maybe they couldn't decide. You know, I guess they couldn't decide whether Miz was going to cash in or not. In the end, they decided he wasn't. Well, oh fucking well. So, the Miz is still got the Money in the Bank. He's in shock about losing to Daniel Bryan. Randy Orton's the new WWE Champion. This match really started on a downer note, and it really became a C-minus match. Overall, final run for this pay-per-view, I have to give it a C+. It was better than average for a WWE pay-per-view, but it's not the best they've ever produced. It was slightly above average. Frankly speaking, I don't think they're going to do much better with Hell in a Cell. And speaking of Hell in a Cell, what the hell? 2 weeks? 2 weeks? You've got to be fucking kidding me. 2 fucking weeks. You know, WWE, you've got some serious issues. Do you think that all of us have six-figure jobs and that we can just buy your pay-per-views consistently? Build up! You know, you're going to record one WWE Raw, and you have two Raws back-to-back recorded tonight, And that's going to tell your whole story leading up to this pay-per-view. Yes, that's really going to make people want to drop 50 fucking bucks again 2 weeks after they just dropped 50 fucking bucks on another pay-per-view. That's bullshit. And this has been the bottom of the barrel. Scraping shit off, and I am done.